Excuse me, sir. You work here?
No, I just hang around here for fun. Joking. How can I help you, friend?
Listen, I know this sounds crazy. Some dumb old coot I know is telling me there's these houses you can buy pre-cut.
Not crazy, friend. The very latest in modern convenience. Convenient and cost-efficient. Which house do you want? Each one is entirely unique, but also the same.
Excuse me?
Perhaps I'm going too fast, sir. Do you want to buy a house?
I think so.
I'll give you a luxurious, entirely unique pre-cut palace. And if you order today, I guarantee your home in a matter of weeks, maybe sooner.
I'll take that one.
Ah, yes, we have that one in stock.
And I already got credit from the bank.
Oh, fantastic. You write your name here, and you sign your name there, and you will be the proud owner of a factory-built home.
It's that easy.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Martin. Albert Cakes, Esquire, at your service.
You boys give me a minute.
Oh. What are you doing here? Everything okay?
I'm not sure. Probably. A fella came by the farm. Got attacked on the road. He said the Skinner brothers was hanging around. Lots of them. Left Uncle armed to the teeth back at the ranch.
Who are these two?
Guns for hire. If this Skinner's about, we need him.
We ain't got that kind of money, Charles.
You want to get robbed for your house?
No, but...
Hey, these Skinners can be nasty. Come on. Mr. Devon, you're with me. Mr. Wayne, this is...
Milton. Jim Milton.
Sir, good to meet you.
We're gonna be heading up to the Manzanita Post.
Why?
The best smith around is that Norwegian fella up there.
So they say. You boys ready?
Yes, sir, we're ready.
Good, because you're about to get shot at over a goddamn hammer.
You want to build a house with a sniper rifle, then?
I know old Niels real well. I'll get you a good deal.
Thank you, sir. All right, then. Let's go buy us some tools.
I know the quickest way. Follow me.
Say, is your friend a Negro or a Redskin?
I think a bit of both, for what it's worth.
Cash is cash, though it's all the same to me. I saw you getting skittish there, but don't you worry. We're not getting shot at.
Oh, yeah. I know Charles Smith. If he's got cause to be concerned, it's usually good cause.
You got a shotgun messenger sitting right beside you, all right? I suppose you don't know much about robbing caravans.
Not much, I guess. No.
Well, nor do I. But I know a thing or two about protecting them. And if a robber sees some strong men sitting up front, two of them guns for hire, then they're gonna wait for the next set of fools to come on through.
Unless they take the guns to mean they're carrying something valuable. Instead of pre-cut timber and some tools.
What? No. Wait. Look, trust me on this. You are overthinking it. You hire a gun, you hire peace of mind and a deterrent. So I'll sit here looking big and scary, and you can concentrate on the horses.
All right. I'll do just that.
Maybe I've done this kind of thing before, and maybe I can handle a weapon. But I'm not so different from you, partner.
I think you might be.
We're taking the next right, up towards Manzanita Post.
Okay, now, back to what you were saying.
People wonder how you can handle it, living by your gun. But it's the same as any other occupation, really. When I get home, I put my gun on the rack and it stays there. I mean it, it really stays there. I don't even think about it. My mind's on my wife and the little ones. I'm chopping wood, mending the roof, putting the kids to bed. But when I'm out here, I'm watching the tree line. I got my gun at the ready. And I'm trying to make my employer as comfortable as possible.
That's, real good of you.
You're in good hands. I know this country well.
Good. Am I finally gonna meet this tool maker?
Now, Niels, he's an acquired taste, but boy, can he work metal. Norwegian, you see? Viking blood. Fellas up there used to worship a god with a hammer. Guess it figures they'd still be making them. I'm not sure how much English he speaks, but Niels knows tools. And he knows me, so we'll see if we can get him to give you some.
This is the spot, just up ahead.
Okay.
You boys wait here. After you, Mr. Milton.
Go speak to the man. Buy your tools, John. I want to get out of here.
Like I said, Nils is an acquired taste. Let me do the talking.
There he is, working away.
Nils. Nils, it's me. Willard Wayne.
Okay.
This is my associate, Jim Milton.
Okay.
He heard you was the best. Best smith around. He needs some tools. He's building a ranch house up at Beecher's Hope.
Beecher's Hope? Okay.
Have you got any made?
Okay.
Like I said, an acquired taste, but a heart of gold, and he's the best. You off someplace, Nils?
Okay.
So Milton is working with Cakes Hardwood and Timber in town. Should I get them to pay you and add it to his bill up there?
Okay.
Come on, let's get moving.
Okay.
All right then, Beecher's Hope. They've been trying to sell that property for some time, haven't they? Took a look at it myself, as it so happens. Seemed like a lot of work. Too much for me. But more power to you. Must have seen something in it I couldn't. World needs men like you.
Everyone find some cover! Get the others!
Right.
God
damn!
Keep your head down! Where'd that come from?
He's running at you! Watch it!
It's
look
the
out.
Skinner! You okay?
Let's stay down! Willard, how you hold up there? We'll get you out of here. Watch the arrows!
They're on the other side! Look out!
Hold on over there!
They're pulling back! Come to the wagon!
All right. You alive?
For now. Mr. Devon, you okay?
Yes.
Is that the last of them?
I think so.
There's more! They got the tools!
They grabbed Mr. Wayne!
All right, you stay here, guard the wagon. Charles, come on!
They got me! Help! I see him! Help me! Mr. Milton, Mr. Smith! Over here! Mr. Devon!
We've walked into something. Get some cover.
You mean they drew us in? We have to get past them.
They climbed up in the trees. Shoot the ones up there first.
Let's move!
He took him down the hill! More! We
I'll take your ears. We're making your friends, John.
They're in our way.
I'm hit.
Found the tools. Now, where's Mr. Shit. All right. Jesus. We gotta move fast. Come on.
Let's go. Back to the road.
A few minutes ago, he was chewing my ear off.
He knew what he was getting into.
Did he?
Skinner. Everyone knows.
Except me.
Later, John.
Charles, you all right carrying him?
I got it. There's no use in you getting bloody, too.
Is it bad?
They opened him up pretty good. Nearly chopped his head in two.
God damn them!
Uh-huh. Mr. Wayne didn't make it!
Dear whore, no.
We have to get out of here. You take him in the back wagon. Come on, help me!
All right. Let's get out of here.
Nothing nice. Got it. Come on.
We gotta go.
Shit. Those goddamn animals. Okay. John, I'm riding with you. Get us back to Beaches.
Those were the Skinner brothers.
I told you I was worried.
Sadie said something, too. What kind of land have I bought?
It's not the land. The Skinners move around. But they're here for now.
I thought this kind of bloodshed was meant to be over with. What was all the nonsense about civilization?
This kind of bloodshed is different. Folks have been killed, sure. For good reason and bad. But rarely just for the fun of it.
That was fun for them?
No, not that time. Most folk don't usually put up with such a fight.
Then I hope we put an end to it.
There was a caravan. A few months back, massacred. Men, women, children. Ended up like Wayne. Or worse.
Uncle! Uncle! Uncle!
I was...
You useless sack of crap.
I was keeping guard.
Really?
Whoa. What happened?
Skinner brothers.
Bottom?
Enough.
Once this is done, I'll take Mr. Devon back to town. I'm gonna pull Mr. Wayne buried.
Okay. Be careful.
Well, I will. But I'm fairly sure we scared him off for now.
Bad business. Well, we'll be safe together.
Sure. If you say so.